Friends, Auto Group on Export is back, and I've got an update on bundling, so let's get cracking. Friends, you can find Tinkercad at tinkercad.com. Of course, it runs in a web browser. There's also an iPad app, and you can simply sign in with Google. Now, last week, there was something called Auto Group on Export. If you've got a hole and a solid, and you export, it actually cuts the hole in. It's magical, and that was taken away. But I need you to take a moment to thank the Tinkercad devs because they heard your complaints, and it's been brought back. Of course, this all ties in with the bundle update I'm sharing today. Hopefully, when you're done today, you'll be more impressed with both. Today, we're going to start by clicking Create, and we're going to do a brand new 3D design. I like to start by naming files because they're easier to find later. I'm going to call this one Bundle 101. Now in Tinkercad, we have always built with solids. You can cruise solids on top of other solids. You can also just bring your solids out and set them on the work plane. If you want to cut something into something with Tinkercad, you can just slide them into each other like this. Once it's set and down, I've got it all lined up. Traditionally, we would grab these two and do Control G to group them. These red lines mean that a cut is happening, and after a moment, you'll see that Tinkercad is thinking right here. And there you can see the cut wraps up, and that cylinder part was cut away. This is how Tinkercad has always worked, with holes and solids. Notice this one is still floating on top because it wasn't part of what I grouped. Now, if we look at this, it is now called a union group. This is the picture for it, and there is another type of group right here called a bundle group. You saw the red line a moment ago while Tinkercad was thinking. Watch this. If I just cruise a lot of these shapes on top of each other, I'm just making something silly. Pop, 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 pop. If I grab these four shapes and I hit bundle group, it happens instantly. There's no wasted time in your design as Tinkercad is thinking. Now you may say, hey, why would I do this? That shape is silly. Maybe you've made a room in your house or a kitchen and you just want to keep the furniture together and there's nothing being cut out. These bundles are the way to do that quickly and still allow you to move, scale, adjust however you need. Now there is another awesome reason. I'm going to show you that really quickly. I'm going to delete these as well, and we're going to make a quick house. Under settings, I'm going to move my size to a little bit larger. I'm going to go by 400 by 400. When I click out here, that becomes real, and then bringing out the sketch tool, I'm going to just draw the outside of a house. This is going to highlight another cool feature. I am going to zoom in to get it on a 20 by 20 grid spot. That just makes it so the lines match a little better. Now, I'm going to make my house like this. I'm going to set my snap grid to 5, so that way it's easy to get on the corners. And I'm just going to snap these out to whatever numbers I pick. 90 by 190. I'm going to come up here, bring it across, and then just connect this again right there. All right, so let me highlight this quick. I love that we can double-click, grab a side, and just stretch it to the size we really wanted. This is a slick way, because we have those settings set to 5 millimeters, to just make a fun house that you want to build with. Notice this point's really useless, so I can also come over here and hit the minus sign, and bingo, now I've got straight sides. The bonus of that is when I click on them, I can double check the measurements, and they're all nice numbers to work with. Now instead of 105 and 165, I'm going to just go one chunk over and one chunk up. So now I've got even numbers on all those sides. It's just more fun when you're fiddling with the math, if you care. With that in place, I'm going to do another fun thing. Let's switch to the width. And I want to make these like they're 6-inch walls. Now, they're not really 6 inches. I'm just playing in metric here. But let's just pretend they are by hitting 6. Pressing enter, and then I'm also going to switch them to be on the outside. So that means my inside area is going to match those measurements that I had a moment ago. Just a fun way to work with math, maybe if you're a school teacher or somebody building a real house. Of course, once you've got your walls, pick whatever height you want. So once again, we're here talking about why bundles are awesome. Check this out. If you go over here and you search door, under community, check it out. There are doors built in. I'm going to bring in this one. I'm going to set it down. And there, after a moment, is our awesome door. Check out the sweet details, all right? So this is a fantastic free design created by Sarah Kath. If you haven't checked her out, I'll make sure her profile is in the description. She is wonderful. And this is a shape that we can just use. So here is how bundling becomes epic. We're going to bring out a cube. We're going to match this cube to the shape of this. So see how it says 10.5 by 18.8. We're just going to take our cube and change its dimensions. Remember, it was 10.5. There is our 18.80. Let's grab these, do L for align, make this one the boss, choose center and center. So that way we're sure this door is inside the hole. Now we're gonna create a bundle. Once again, this is Control B. Bang, it turns green, it's instant. We can scale it to any size. So right now I'm going to shift stretch so it looks like it fits my house. I think that's going to be pretty nifty. I want to make sure it's in the middle of that wall. I'm just going to use the arrow keys to get it so that it's close. Remember, my nudge was set at 5. If I set it back to 1 millimeter, that allows me to get it so it lines up at the front. And friends, this was a bundle group. It was instant. If we grab the rest of our project and do Control G, that is a union group. Here is where the magic happens. That bundle group cut the hole, but it did not cut out the door. You have just added a fantastic door to your project in an instant. Now I want to add windows as well, so I am going to un-union group this. I'm going to tell you this again and again and again. If you nest your groups, it slows Tinkercad down. If you check this video in the corner, it does explain it. If you design smart, it makes the rest of your Tinkercad process so much more efficient. So let's go back to the trick here. Let's search. Let's type window. Let's see if anybody made a cool one for us. We have got so many fun options. I'm going to pick this one right here. It's a window 4-pane. I'm going to drop it in and notice it's huge. Trust me, it doesn't matter. Here's the trick. Click on it. Check its measurements. 54 by 66. Let's go back to our basic shapes. Bring out a cube. Once again, was this the 66? Yes, it was. And this one was the 54. Type those measurements so they match. Select them. L for align. Let's make this one the boss. Choose center and center. And then bundle group. So now that we've got this, do shift scale to get it to the size you want. I think that looks pretty good for my building. I'm going to move this into place. Once again, just use nudge to get it so I think it's going to be nifty when it pokes out. I'm going to do control up or control shift up to move it to where I want. I want more than one window, so I'm going to do control D. Shift nudge to move it across. And you can continue this as much as you want. Now I'm going to pick this one and I'm going to make it larger now so that it matches those. I'm going to click on these two and I'm going to do control down to move them a little lower, a little over to the other side. And friends, as you build like this, when you're done, select your house. Once again, control G to union group. Of course, you've got the red lines for the union group thinking time. But after a while, bang! You have got an awesome house. Double click, click on the building. Let's pick a cooler color. I'm going to go with a nice wood brown, maybe like this, or maybe even something crazy and pink. Whatever it does, when you are finished and click outside, the edit completes and you are using bundle groups the way they were intended. All right, so let me wrap up by explaining this once again. The right way to do this was to do the union group, so those cut out. But I do want to let you know again that Tinkercad has re-enabled, where if you bring two parts that are going to cut into each other and you export them like this, I'll even show you again. If you choose export and you export them as an STL, I'm going to just leave it in my downloads and have the funny name for it. If we quickly bounce to our slicer, I'm going to choose create new project, and we're going to bring that file in. Check it out. It did the cut for us automatically. Super cool, but it is not really the right way to do it. Once again, if we would have just taken these two and done Control G to union group them right here, it's the exact same step that's happening, except you're trusting Tinkercad to do it for you instead of you hitting Control G. Friends, as I wrap up, couple things I want to highlight. My first bundle video is up above. It is useful too. You can check it out. There will be more bundle videos coming as well. There are lots of features that make it better when you're actually building stuff in SimLab, and it speeds up the design process the more you work on it. One other huge benefit is if we each are building smarter designs, there's less stress on the server. Tinkercad is wonderful because it can do brute force things, but if everybody is doing brute force projects, that stresses the server. So the more we build smarter, the better the servers run, and the better everybody's experience should be. And of course, just like every new feature I highlight in Tinkercad, these will be added to my playlist dedicated to new features. Of course, you can use the link or the bit.ly up above to find it. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that support me via YouTube memberships. There are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. Of course, with any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, a massive shout out to my Patreon support group. Love how that group is growing. We're past 200 members. It has a fantastic messaging area that is free to everybody. And of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to say thanks to you. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Of course, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.